Hi there guys, welcome to Guitar Interactive magazine. My name's Tom Quayle, and I'm back with an amplifier review this time. Now here we've got quite an interesting amplifier. These are basically a reissue of a very, very classic amp from the 70s designed by Tommy Walker for Music Man. And these were really sought after for a very long time. And there was a big period where they weren't available anymore. And they were really renowned for their fantastic clean tone. Great platform for pedals, with a couple of different channels, and just a fantastic tone with a particular design that was unique to the amplifier at the time. So this is actually the reissue. This is the Music Man 212 HD 130, and the 130 stands for 130 watts. So a significant amount of power here. Now the interesting thing in terms of the design, this was actually put together by Music Man and Marco De Vigilis, I hope I pronounced that right, from DV Mark, who make phenomenal products these days in the guitar and bass business, particularly well known in the bass world with Mark Bass. They make great products and have a very big following, and they've teamed up with, or Music Man have teamed up with them to produce this amplifier. And the particular interesting thing that's the same as the originals is it's actually a solid state front end, which these days people are a bit scared by for some reason. They think everything has to be tube. But you'd be really surprised that this amplifier, if you've never heard one of these before, because as I say, they were not available for a very long time, it's got this great solid state front end, but has this power section, which is basically based on four EL34s as their output stage, giving 130 watts, plus this ECC83 or 12AX7 driver that's in the power stage. But the actual preamp section is completely solid state. Now, this is not designed to be a high-gain, modern-sounding beast of an amplifier. This is all about great bell-like clean tones. It does break up as you turn it up. There's a significant amount of clean headroom, but as you turn it up, you can drive it. But realistically, what you want to think of this of is great clean tones and a fantastic platform for pedals. Now, if we go through the amplifier itself, on the front panel, we've got this fantastic looking facade, very classic kind of good looks. We'll all recognize the kind of influence in terms of the design. We've got two channels, each with two separate inputs, okay? Now, the first channel is very simple in its nature. It's basically just four dials and a bright and normal switch. So we can go from normal to bright in terms of the channel. And then we've got volume, treble, middle, and bass. So your standard three-band EQ. When we move over to the second channel, we've got the same thing, volume, treble, middle and bass, and normal and bright, but in addition we've got spring reverb, and then tremolo controls, intensity and speed, really, really nice tremolo, this very organic sounding, master volume, and then a global deep and normal switch, which is based in the power section. So you can basically tighten up or fatten up the bottom end as you so wish, okay? So we're plugged into channel two because channel two gives us the option to show you the reverb and tremolo effect as well. In all of the senses, if we were to plug into channel one, we get exactly the same sound, but without the extra effects on board. So first thing I'll do, we've set this up, let's set everything roughly to about halfway as you normally do with these kind of things, so up to about five. And I just want to show you the reverb really quickly. So the reverb, about five, treble about five, and we get this. The volume is on about three, master volume also on about three. We're mic'd up here with this amazing Neumann mic that's running into our, obviously, studio gear, and we get this sound using my neck pickup on my Fibonacci. It's a fabulous bell-like tone, beautiful dynamic response, again, in terms of pick attack and in terms of the dynamics. Every single nuance that I play is being translated beautifully through the amplifier. Now, in terms of the speakers that we've got here, these are DV Mark Neo Classic speakers. They're a custom speaker made by DV Mark. It's two 12-inch speakers, hence 212, and then we've got 130 watts of power. Now, the speakers will actually take 300 watts, so you know you can crank this thing all the way up and you're not going to damage your speakers at all. So no worries in terms of power output. Now, what we'll do is we'll start by, I'm just going to show you, if you crank the volume and turn the master down, that you can drive the amp, but there's an awful lot of headroom here, which we can't show you all the headroom because I'm sat next to the amplifier, and if I turn it all the way up, 130 watts, I'll go deaf. So I'm going to roll the volume all the way up to about 8, and then obviously drop the master down, and then just let you hear how it breaks up. If I go to my bridge pickup, which is a moderately, it's like a PAF style, a vintage output, it's not mega output. You can hear how it's breaking up. But it's breaking up in a smooth, pleasing way. It's not an ugly, harsh sound. So if you wanted to, you could push that even further. We could go to 10 and then roll the master down a little bit further. Let's just bring the treble up a little bit to add more brightness. Okay, and we're on the normal setting here, not the bright setting. So it will do that sound if you so desire. However, if we roll back to about 4 and roll the master volume up, this is how most people are running the amp. Beautiful dynamic bell-like clean tones. Okay, the reverb sounds great as well. Classic spring reverb. If I turn that all the way off, where are we? There we go. We get this. Which is still a huge amount of fun to play, but obviously the reverb just adds something special into the mix. Okay, EQ controls. In fact, let's do the bright switch first. We might as well do that, seeing as it's first in the channel. Now, this is quite a pronounced effect and gives you, again, even more highs. Let's turn that down a little bit so we don't clip the front end of the mic. So. Very pretty. Again, got that classic American bell-like tone, which is really, really useful to have. So let's turn that off for now, because we're going to try some pedals through this in a bit, and that's not going to work that well with pedals. It's great on its own, though. So treble control, let's sweep through this and let you hear how musical this is. So all the way off, we get this. Almost like a jazzy tone. And then as we roll this back in again, so even at 10, still super musical. It's not barking at you or too harsh in the high end. So let's roll that back down. Now the mids, again, very powerful control. Let's roll those down to 0. What I like about these mids in this style of amplifier is it really allows you to cut through the mix in a band scenario with a clean tone, which can be quite difficult. So very nice again. And then the bass. Serious amount of low end thunk if you so desire. But still very musical. Very musical indeed. So let's roll that back down again to a sensible level. So very nice EQ section. Let's check out the tremolo. So if we bring the speed up and the intensity very slowly. So that's a subtle setting. We increase the intensity. It's So very, very cool tremolo sounds. And again, the speed will go pretty high if you so desire. Very nice indeed. Okay, the master volume does exactly what you'd expect, obviously, and then the deep switch. Okay, here's without. And then with, same thing. Adds a lot of thunk and kick into the bottom end, okay? Now, what I'll do is, I want to show you how this reacts with pedals. And down on the floor here, we've got a overdrive pedal, quite a light gain, kind of Tube Screamer-esque kind of thing, and a delay pedal. Now, there's no effects loop on the back. What you do have on the back is an 8 ohm and a 16 ohm output for an extension cab as well. The internal speakers are 8 wide to 8 ohms. And a standby switch, and that's about it. There's no effects loop on there because it's designed to be run as a clean amp, so you plug everything in the front end and then you get the tube warmth and everything is rosy and sounds fantastic. So let's do the delay first. So this is running straight into the front end. Sounds beautiful, really working very nicely. There's no weird artifacts or anything, it just sounds great. Okay, and there's no extra noise or anything. Now if we run the overdrive pedal as well, we get this kind of a sound. And again, this is super smooth, super dynamic, works great with pedals. If we crank the mids a little bit, so a really, really great sounding amplifier in a, it's about 19 kilograms, between 19 and 20, so not incredibly heavy for an amp of this size. So pretty portable, very sturdy handle on the top. But what you're getting is great tone with less unreliability issues because there's less tubes in there. So you've got a solid state front end. Great power section, really, really loud with tons of clean headroom. Two channels, two inputs on there, plug a couple of guitars in, you're away basically. Great for pedals. So, as a reissue, there's a lot of people been asking for this amplifier from Music Man over the years. This is going to make a lot of people happy. And to those who are new to the Music Man HD series, this is going to be a great amplifier for you to check out if you need a clean tone that's great for pedals or just a clean tone in general that's going to work and be very versatile with tremolo and reverb effects built in. Comes very, very highly recommended. Great sounding amplifier with a great feel. So, hope you've enjoyed the review, guys, and I will see you next time.